Welcome back to the Rhode Show. This morning in the buzz, we turned the clocks forward over the weekend. If you didn't, it's 8:30, losing an hour of sleep Saturday night. And this change not only wreaks havoc with our internal body clocks, it also causes a spike in car crashes. Study shows that there's a 17% increase in traffic fatalities on the Monday after we spring forward. Researchers blame a lack of sleep for most drivers and say the time change takes about a week for people to adjust to. So you may want to reach for an extra cup of coffee before getting behind the wheel today. So we wanted to know if everybody's like kind of feeling off the game. You doing okay?
I'm a bit tired.
You're tired? Okay.
However, I had an awful night's sleep every day this weekend.
Yes.
So I think I'm not the right candidate
right.
for
and
this.
Right, and you're not blaming the time change.
No, yeah. I'm not blaming right. the time right. change for that. I have other things to
yes.
blame.
Gotcha. 10-4.
But I think especially a day like today where we were even mentioning this morning that, hey, the sun should be up by now.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be up at this time, but because there's snow and clouds,
it was cloudy.
You know, you're waking up what seems like an hour earlier to you.
Right.
With your body clock, but you're also waking up to kind of dreary weather.
Which
so
doesn't
without
help.
The sun, you're going to feel
yeah.
even more tired.
Yeah, I think the sun was supposed to come up at like 7:06 today, mm-hmm. and by 7:12 we were all sitting around going, where's the sun? What's happening? Why isn't the sun coming?
Didn't we do this for a reason?
Yeah, why isn't it getting even a little brighter out this morning? I'm mm-hmm. fine today. I feel a little off today.
Maybe because you were a party animal last night.
At 6 o'clock at night. Come on, woo! We were raising the roof at 6, maybe 7. We were pushing it. But I don't feel so bad today. The time change, I'm really looking forward to having the sun out later. And I'm looking
yes.
forward to the weather tomorrow, knowing that it's going to be a nice day tomorrow. And hopefully we'll mm-hmm. be able to see the sun. Some people, as far as driving, I don't know if we can ever really tell here. And look, I love everybody here in Rhode Island. I really do. But can we really blame the time change on bad drivers? Because, you know, you've been on 95 and you know how bad the drivers are on 95 Monday through Friday, any
yeah.
time of year, never mind just when the clocks
get moved. That is a tough thing to
quick.
Say. I think we always look for an excuse. Oh, it's the potholes.
Yeah,
oh,
no.
Now it's the daylight
no,
savings.
No, it really isn't.
Well, what happens on a really nice day in the spring when all the potholes are filled?
Yeah, what happens when the potholes are filled, the sun is out on a real nice day, probably in like June or July, you've had time to adjust and you're still being cut off on 95 or 195 or someplace like
that. I can understand that when it happens now because you think it happens over a weekend.
Right.
So you're not really doing, you
adjusting
know, if you're in a job Monday through Friday, you just kind of relax and you can take your time. So it's today that it hits you.
And I think, as you were saying, because the sun's not out, because it's kind of cloudy this
yeah.
morning, I think that actually made it even worse.
It makes it feel extra
yes.
earlier. Brendan. Hey, Brendan.
Yeah.
Brendan,
oh,
wake
hi.
Up.
Hi.
He's sleeping.
Well, still feeling the effects, you guys. But, you know, I'm adjusting well accordingly. And our Facebook friends have lots of comments on this topic here this morning. Paul Cowell gets things started for us today, saying, I am never off my game, time change or not.
Yeah,
there you
sounds
go.
Sounds like he's on top of things.
Focus no matter what. And Giovanni has had enough. He says, let's see. No energy savings. People are extra grouchy. And our internal clocks are messed up. Sounds like the time is right to ditch this useless ritual.
Right.
And finally, Sloppy Joe feels the way many of us probably do today, I'm sure, saying, ugh. Yesterday went by so fast, mm-hmm. I don't feel like I had a weekend at all.
Yeah,
there you go.
Yesterday did go by
quick.
Fast.
Flew by. Well, trending today. For-